galaxy of entertainers. Tonight it's the NHL again. The Lightning in Colorado.
Set to go for the second period. They thought they were set to go for the first period.
With the shot, it's tipped by Henrique off the glass and up into the netting out of play.
Moving that puck back to Lovejoy. He bobbled it. Domestika busts away. Cutting in on Schneider. Shoots. Saved by Corey Schneider.
He almost got his first goal as the Tampa Bay Lightning, too. A nice little play. Vladdy Domestika, one of the things we don't talk about much is how darn fast he is. He is such a smooth skater. He pulled away from that defense, made a really good shot. But a really nice save there, too, by Schneider. And then watch point. Look at the cool hands by a guy just out of junior hockey. Didn't quite get the shot away that he wanted, but that little curl and drag. Brayden Point all alone for a second. What he tried to do and what he had to do was pull the puck away from the goaltender.
Hands it off, gets it back for Barkov. Looks to make a play. Jágr well surrounded in the slot. It's tapped in front. Domestikov had lost his stick. In his own zone, he's able to glove it.
On that one, there's a look at Vladdy Domestika. Watch how smart he is here in this play. He's going to end up getting his stick knocked out of his hand right there. Now, the puck's going to come back around to him, but he doesn't panic. You can't close your hand on the puck. See that? He waited just for a second. That was awesome. In your own zone, you are allowed to move the puck ahead with your hand. You cannot do it in the offensive zone, but he did it in the defensive zone.
Start to his career. This is just his fourth game, but he scores the game winner in the shootout a couple of nights ago. He's at the ice right now with Brian England. Brayden, you're three games into your NHL career. What's your world been like so far?
It's been a lot of fun. Obviously, it's pretty exciting to play in this league and to play against the fans all the time, so it's been awesome.
Every night you see different star players. What's that been like for you to handle that now that you're out on the ice against them?
Just trying to relax. Obviously, it's pretty cool. I mean, you watch these guys all the time, and getting to play against them, it's, like I said, it's just been a lot of fun.
You scored a goal to shoot in the game the other day. I saw the look on your face when you came by the bench. You look really calm and relaxed. What were you really feeling when you came over here?
Yeah, obviously excited. You know, they still had to make a save, so you don't get too fired up. But, you know, he did that, and then it's happening.
First of many, I hope. Good luck.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Still looking for the puck.
Two guys from the 2013 draft. They know each other very well. Played junior hockey, won a Memorial Cup together.
Yeah, exactly. These two guys played on the same line at times. Two different kinds of players. And when Nathan MacKinnon came in, he really took the league by storm. He ended up winning the Calder Trophy. And he was still 18 years old at the end of the year when he won it. Well, Jonathan Drouin came to the Tampa Bay Lightning, wasn't quite ready. He went back that first year and played junior. Then he came back, and we've talked about him over the last couple of years, but he's just starting to come into his own. I think things are going to even out an awful lot. Again, he's played already more playoff games than MacKinnon has, but Nathan MacKinnon has blinding speed. When he talked about Matt Duchene a moment ago, this kid's got another gear on top of that. He was a big part of Team North America in the World Cup and has come in really in terrific shape this year and is off to a great start. So is this guy, Jonathan Drouin, who got to play with his old teammate on that Team North America. He came in great shape as well. The shootout goal that he scored the other day, just one of the many things actually that both of these two guys do well. If we get to a shootout tonight, I'd almost bet money that both of them are going to be in it. They have that ability to make about six or seven different moves, and whatever it takes to score a goal, they're really outstanding. Two exciting players to watch.
Vlad Domestikov will join Paul in the upcoming Gulf Coast Honda Dealer's second intermission report. We'll meet to tonight's community hero reaction from the Lightning being named the number one franchise. Coming out number one, they'll have that coming up in the intermission. Machine scoring from Wierkosz.
Welcome to the Hunter Intermission Report. We've skated through two periods of play, and twice tonight, Matt Duchene has scored for Colorado in the final minute of action. It's 2-0 Avalanche. Vladdy Domestika
just off the ice, joins us now. So what is your frame of mind when that happens to this team once again?
You know, we talked about it before the game. We can't let it happen. But, it happened, and, you know, we have to keep moving forward, and we still have 20 minutes to go, and the guys will be ready to go.
In particular, what problems does Colorado present to you tonight?
I think they're using their speed. They're obviously a skilled, fast team, and they're putting pucks deep and cycling it down low. I think we have to do the same thing, too.
You have over 2 minutes on the power play. How are you trying to find space as a team, you yourself, and generate more shots?
I think we're letting Varlamov see too many shots, and I think we have to get into space a little bit more, and I think our goals will come.
You're a veteran now in this league. In your first two games, both Detroit and New Jersey, you trailed 2-0. So how do you approach the third period? You've been in this hole before. How do you get out?
Keep plugging away, sticking to the system, and hope things, good things will happen.
All right. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
Vermont, as she forms the Star-Spangled Banner in O Canada. Tonight's colors are presented by the Ottawa Bylaw Service.
Now you see those players, obviously you understand how skilled they are and how fast they are, and have to make sure we play smart defensively and to make the turnovers to the blue lines and put the puck deep and work their G's hard. Well, we have to stick to the system. Last couple of games we let the lead slip away at the beginning, and we were kind of chasing the game, and it's Colorado, they're a skilled team, and we have to come and play Lightning hockey from the first minute.
Remember what he said to me last year when I said, "Coach, everybody wants you to shoot?" He said, "Hey, I'm a Russian. When I see a chance to pass, I pass. That's what we do." I started to laugh when he said that, but it was true. It was very authentic what he was feeling.
You interviewed Brian after the at the Fan Fest. What was that line? He had a pretty good one.
He got hit by Coburn accidentally doing a drill, and Coburn felt so bad. He said, go on, you can punch me in the nose, it's okay. Brian didn't do it, but I asked him, I said, were you tempted to? He jokingly said, nah, I didn't want to break my head. Was that Cody Ceci with Johnson there at the red line? I didn't catch the number there.
I think it was Smith.
Oh, it was Smith, okay. 15, not 5. Tyler Johnson got his helmet ripped off for his troubles. Yeah, you're right, 15. Oh, that's a slew foot. That's a big-time slew foot. Kicked his feet out from underneath him and then roughed him up. Smith trying to get something going for his teammates there. Boy, he...
Lightning Live inviting you to an evening of play in the National Hockey League. Tonight, Tampa Bay skates into Toronto in the Air Canada Center and faces its Atlantic Division rival in the Maple Leafs. It's just the second road test of the season for the Bolts and Vlad Nemestikov. His power play goal opened the scoring in a 4-1 win over Ottawa on Saturday. That was game one of 6 straight. Nemestikov, a goal and an assist on special teams.
Yeah, they've been working on getting into the zone with possession. You see, this is Nemestikov with the circle. He darts through the middle of the box. What really Ottawa's trying to do is they're trying to keep that nice tight box, get in shooting lanes. In last year, again, in the power play, we saw a lot of shots blocked. I think this year they're making a conscious effort of trying to get through the middle of the box, trying to break down that box. You see Nemestikov going from in front of the net to the side of the net to be available. And I like that about him. I like how smart he is to do that. Here's Hedman tries to take a shot. He tries to get it through. And then ends up being the goal. After standing in front of the net, he now is able to help out with Kucherov to be available. That's good hockey IQ where you know where you got to be on the ice. And then he makes a terrific pass all the way across the Stamkos. Carlson is kind of leaning towards Palat, threads the needle through, and then Stamkos makes no mistake. But maybe that's the guy that they're looking for.
Here is young Vlad Nemestikov on the success of the power play.
I thought the last game we moved the puck really well. We got pucks through, and we had people up the net, and 2-1 in, so that's good.
His first 2 points of the season, the goal and the assist. Once again, Vlad Nemestikov, as mentioned, took a tally the other night, and he is at the Bolt bench right now with Brian Englund.
Vladdy had a
goal and an assist last game against Ottawa. Both of them were on the power play. In fact, you're getting a lot of power play time. Is that giving you a lot of offensive confidence?
Yeah, of course. Obviously, when you're on the power play, you get more confidence. But you have to take one power play at a time and keep working hard.
You're playing with Stamkos and Kucherov now after starting the first couple of games playing with Filppula. Are you seeing more offensive opportunities and offensive situations, maybe offensive zone starts playing with these two guys?
Probably, yeah, but it doesn't matter who you play with. You just have to, you know, go out there and play your game. But obviously they're two skilled forwards, and it's always fun playing with them.
What do you expect from this game here tonight against Seattle?
Well, they're a young, fast team, so it's going to be a fast game. And, you know, we got to match that speed and play well.
Thanks, Vladdy. Good luck.
Thank you.
All right, Brian, with his size, too, Vlad is so versatile, and he has the speed to keep up with anyone on the attack.
And I think that's what Steve Yzerman likes about him and John Cooper's. You can put him anywhere up and down the lineup. We've seen him on the fourth line playing with, right, you know, with Boyle and Brown. We've seen him all the way now on in the first line. So, you know, good for him. This is a guy that can do everything on the ice. Very responsible defensively, and that's why you can put him with Stamkos and Kucherov. Is he might be the guy that's able to puck manage, be able to get the puck, you know, in the right spot. So, and we, you know, we always underestimate, you know, his offensive ability, as we saw the other night.
Yeah, he skates tonight on the top line with Steven Stamkos and Nikita Kucherov as the Bolts play in Toronto.
I couldn't believe it, because I just thought he took it off the head, and then our trainer came to the bench and he opened his hand. I couldn't believe how big Ben's teeth actually are. So. But gutty effort, and he was, that's why, you know, we talked to him, and it was just, I guess, the way the vibration knocked his teeth loose, so apparently they were fake anyway.